Hey folks, well, here we are with a successful attempt at creating the clock that I designed in one of my previous videos. So what we're going to do today is I'm going to show you all of the failures. I'm going to show you and explain why I failed, show you what I did for the first couple of times, and the lessons learned. Because this ended up being probably one of my favorite projects because I learned so much about CNC woodworking through these failures and how to adjust to create something that my wife really likes. So this is going to go somewhere in our house. She gets to figure it out, but I'm actually pretty happy with this. Also, this particular design was relatively easy to make and can be replicated, scaled up, down. Of course, the letter might change depending on what it is that that you need to make for. And I really see this becoming a good seller in my shop and in my business. So stick around and let's see how this was done. Okay, so in a previous video, I taught you how to create this general design using VCarve Pro. The file is actually available for download on my website, and I'll put a link below. Of course, I'm leaving out the letter L so you can customize it with whatever you'd like to have in there, if you'd like to have anything. And also, I'm going to put a link to the video if you'd like to design it yourself. Now that those shameless plugs are out of the way, let's go ahead and learn from my mistakes. Now to start off with, once I had joined up some wood, I just used some black spray paint because I'm going to paint the surface and then cut out everything except what I'd like to. Always make sure that the paint dries before you actually start your cut, or you can end up really messing it up. From there, let's go ahead and move to the Onefinity CNC. Now I'm speeding up much of this because I still like to show it off, but you don't want to sit there for a half an hour and watch everything go. Now, in this situation, I actually screwed down the wood with wood screws, but a lot of the time I'll use C8 glue and tape, and really, I kind of like that better. I'm using a 20-degree V-bit for all of the engraving. Now, it's not often that I use painted surfaces on my CNC, so this is really a learning experience for me. I'm using a 1/4 inch upcut bit to hog out the pocket right here, but what you'll see is that I believe because of the paint, it's causing these little pigtails or swirls to actually stick onto the edge. Now, the solution for that, which you'll see in a couple of minutes, is to actually start off by doing the cutout with a downcut bit. In that situation, you don't end up with nearly as many burrs as you see right here. There's still a little bit, but not as much. In the past, that's not been a problem because if there were any burrs that stick onto it, I would just sand that off. But obviously, I can't go back and sand the top because of the paint. Right here, you'll see that using the downcut bit actually gets rid of quite a few of those burrs, but some of them did stick around. And in a couple of situations, when the downcut bit cut the burrs off, it actually pulled a little bit of the paint with it. So in the future, you definitely want to make sure that you use a downcut bit and do your outline first. Now it's at this point that we really see the problem start to arise. At the top of the L, because of the fact that that section is so thin, what happens is the bit actually chips off a lot of that wood. Now my solution for that, instead of going down, I set it to a 16th of an inch, but I think it actually went a little bit deeper. I might have miscalculated my Z probe, but in the future, I changed it so it's only 1/32nd of an inch. So it doesn't go down as deep and it still gives us a nice cut. Here we're doing a cutout and we end up with pretty much the same problem. Those burrs came up. So in the future, I actually changed my design so I would use an 1/8 inch downcut bit because I just actually don't have a 1/4 inch downcut bit. So I need to order one. So let's use the reciprocating saw to cut those tabs. And we have some burrs, which could be cleaned up, But the big problem that you see right here is the fact that the letter actually broke off. Again, that's because it was cut too deep. And so you'll see in the final build that we correct that by not going nearly as deep. Okay, so let's go ahead and move on to attempt number two. The wood that I'm actually using here is wood that came from an old bookshelf that was being thrown out of my school. So I just grabbed it, brought it home, ripped it apart, and now I've got some scrap wood to experiment with. I'm not sure what kind of wood this is. It's very light, it's very brittle, but it's got a neat, rich color to it that I actually like. As you'll see right here, it's doing a much better job of cutting without actually giving us all those burrs. Now that's because we're using a downcut bit here instead of an upcut bit. Now you'll still see that there's a little bit of burr and there's some sawdust in there. And the main reason for that is because I'm not using my dust collection, so you can actually see the cut. Now we use the quarter inch upcut bit to clear out the majority of that pocket for two reasons. One, quarter of an inch is going to get rid of it a lot quicker. And number two, the upcut is going to give us a cleaner bottom surface. And that's really something that we want with the pocket. Although I didn't record it, you'll see when the bit actually cuts inside the letter, we end up with the same problem that it actually chips off the small pieces. And that's mainly because of the fact that it's going too deep and the wood is just not durable enough to hold. It's even worse in this one because the wood that I'm using is kind of brittle. Also, I may have got my XYZ probe a little bit off there and it cut into it a little bit more than it should. Now let's move on to attempt number three. This is the same wood that I was talking about before. So you see it's got a really neat color to it. I really meant for this to just be a test, so I'm not worried about whether or not the wood looks perfect. For this particular cut, I decided to change things up and do an engraving on everything. So I didn't actually cut the pocket as I had in the past. I just decided to do the outlines and the engraving, which you'll see here in just a moment. All right, since there's no paint on there yet, we can move right to sanding. And so any burrs that happen to be on there, we can get rid of. And there are a couple of small ones. So a quick little sand with a 120 to 220 grit gets rid of any burrs that might be there. And here's where the wheels really fall off. Now, if you've watched my channel at all, and if you're a subscriber, you know painting is not my strong suit. I forgot to seal this wood with any kind of lacquer or shellac. And so what ends up happening right here is that paint really soaks in. Because this wood is so brittle, it seems like it's very open poured. So the spray paint really sunk in there. I end up sanding it off and giving it a shot. But by the time I sand off enough of the wood to get rid of the paint that I wanted to get rid of, I'd pretty much sanded into a lot of my engraving. Also, an adjustment that I made was I changed the engraving to only go about a 32nd of an inch deep, so which meant that I didn't have a lot of depth to spare. Here you see a futile attempt to try to sand it off and maybe get something out of it, but by the end of it, I just realized that was the very definition of an epic fail, as the kids would say 15 years ago. Now, before we go any further, I do want to mention that I do have links to all the tools, bits, and products that I use down in the product descriptions. I am an Amazon affiliate, so if you decide to make any purchases from the tools that you see today, please do so through those links. It doesn't cost you a penny more, but Amazon gives me a little bit of a kickback, so it helps support the channel at no cost to you. All right, with all three of those failures, let's move on to some success. So I tried again. I go back to my original design, but I did make a couple of changes. Number one, I changed the depth of cut to only about a 32nd of an inch, so hopefully we won't get that chip out like we saw before. I spray painted it and let it dry overnight to make sure that it was a little bit drier. And then we move on to the cut. Now you'll notice right here that I decided to go ahead and do all of the eighth of an inch cuts, and I cut out that profile first. By doing that, the wood has a lot more stability than it would if I would have hogged out everything with the quarter inch. So this also helps to keep that wood from chipping away, as you can see right here. Now there is a little bit of dust, but that's because I don't have the vacuum on there. Now, when I moved to the quarter inch, I put the vacuum hose on there, but I actually forgot to change the hose out and plug it up to my actual shop vac. So for the first couple of minutes, it's not picking up any kind of dust, but I'll fix that. And here we see it cleaned up pretty well. Now, because of the fact that I was pretty sure that I'd gotten all of my issues worked out, I decided to go ahead and use some walnut, and it turned out looking very nice. Okay, now here's where I did make one small mistake. Remember how I told you that I wanted to use a downcut bit for all the profiles? Well, I forgot. I actually changed the path in VCarve to use my 1/8 inch downcut bit because, once again, I don't have a 1/4 inch downcut bit, but then I forgot and cut it with a 1/4 inch downcut bit. So I let it pass one time, then I pause, swap it out for an 1/8 inch bit. In hindsight, that was really unnecessary because the damage was already done and I have those burrs. So I am going to have to do a little cleanup and hopefully I don't mess it up. So I do swap it out for an 1/8 inch bit, and then I finish up the cut. From there, once I'm finished, I go to the WIM spindle sander and I give it a nice clean up on the corners. Then I pull out my drill, and I've got these handy dandy sanding discs that I found on Amazon. They have grits from 60 grit all the way up to several hundred. I can't remember off the top of my head, but they do a really good job of kind of getting into those corners. I recommend you pick some of those up if you do anything with CNC work. There's a link down in the description. Now, for any of those burrs that stick around and are a little bit harder to get rid of, I take one of those little sanding discs, fold it up, and I actually use that to get into those corners and edges, and that actually does a really good job. I tried doing it with a box cutter and even with my marking knife, but it turned out that just using the little piece of sandpaper right here does a great job. Next, let's move on to drilling the hole. Now, I'd actually forgotten, but I was going to put a hole in the CNC program so it would actually drill it, but I didn't do that, so I had to find center and then just go ahead and drill. Once I got it drilled, I realized that it wasn't a 1/4 inch that needed to be drilled. It needed to be 3/8 of an inch, so I go back and redo it. You can't see it because my shoulder's in the way, but trust me, it was pretty amazing. From there, I apply a liberal coat of shellac and let it dry. I really like shellac because it dries fast, it's natural, it's got a nice smell to it. My only fear is I don't know a lot about shellac, so I'm hoping that it doesn't yellow over time, especially over that white paint, but time will tell. And then we put the clock apparatus, mechanism, whatever big fancy word you want to use. Very simple and easy to do. I've got a link to this clock mechanism down in the description if you'd like to pick one up, because this was a fun project to do and I encourage you to try it. And there we go. I also picked up a 2-foot clock mechanism, and I'm going to do something similar with a larger clock just for fun and see how that turns out.
Hey, so thanks for watching the video all the way through. Again, don't forget to subscribe and the share and the like and the comment and all the things down there, because that's a big deal to me. Also, check out my website at southpawdesigns.com without the U, where you can actually download this design as well as several others for your own projects.